Good morning. My name is Alan Meran, and I am a member of the executive team of the French-American Chamber of Commerce Carolinas. The French-American Chamber of Commerce has launched an initiative to publish short videos to introduce member or key actors of the Carolinas business community. Today, I am with Colin Kiser of EDPNC. First, Colin, can you tell us about yourself?
Alan, thank you. Bonjour to everyone. Again, my name is Colin Kiser with the Economic Development Partnership of North Carolina. A little bit about myself, not a native North Carolinian. I'm from Virginia. I've been in the Raleigh-Durham area for about 8 years with my wife and 2 children, 5 and 8. And we absolutely love it here, just from a quality of life standpoint. But I am, I would hope to consider myself a world citizen. I love to travel. I love football. I'm a big Arsenal fan and love working with international companies trying to come to the USA.
All right. We have many things in common with Arsenal. So what EDPNC is about?
So the Economic Development Partnership of North Carolina is a public-private partnership. We get the majority of our funding from the state legislature, but also supplemented from the private business community. And we were founded over 5 years ago, essentially to grow and support the many different aspects of the North Carolina economy. So the one division that I work in that is associated with business attraction, we work with companies, both domestic and international, that have investments that they need to put into the United States. And what we do is we put forward the advantages of North Carolina to these companies to show them, here's why you should have your investment here. We've got the workforce, we've got the university ecosystem, we've got the different clusters of industries, we have logistics, we have low cost of doing business, all the different things that are important to a business's bottom line and their ability to thrive.
Great. So in the current situation, how COVID-19 has changed anything for your organization?
It's a great question, Alan. A little bit more background on what I specifically do. I work with companies mainly international coming in, but I focus on Europe. So we do have 2 full-time directors in our European office, and they are always scouring the news articles and online and meeting with companies that have investment opportunities. So what we have seen out of Europe in particular, which would be pertinent for this conversation, is that a lot of the small to medium-sized enterprises, the SMEs that were looking to invest, many of them have put those investment plans on hold or canceled them just because they're needing to restructure or reshift their own supply chain needs in Europe or in other parts of the world where they have the majority of their business. So we're seeing some projects shift to a pause or on hold or cancellation phase, whereas other companies are having projects come out of nowhere. Maybe they were exporting into the US and now they see that because of the distance of that supply chain, they need to be in the US. So It's starting certain projects from nothing, whereas it's slowing or stopping other opportunities. So we'll take the good, however it comes, but that's what we're seeing is a major shift. Things are slowing down, and it still remains to be seen how it will play out the rest of the year. But it's busy in North Carolina, so we still have a lot of activity and a lot of inquiries coming in.
All right. Thank you very much, Colin, for
Absolutely.
Your time
Thanks,
and collaboration. Have a nice
Thank
day.
Thank you for your work.
Bye-bye.
All right. Bye-bye.